what's up, everybody? Welcome to The Expanse. Today, we're going to talk some Marvel Studios. And if we're talking Marvel Studios, of course, we're going to be talking Black Panther. Black Panther, I did a review on it previously as far as a non-spoiler review. But this movie has been an absolute smash in the box offices. This movie was released on February the 16th. And in week number one of its release, this is only the domestic numbers. In week number one, it debuted to $242 million. And of course, the number one rankings in the theaters. In week number two, it was one of the, I believe, the fourth or fifth movie of all time that had also an additional 100 plus million in its second week in the box office. And it led week two with 112 million. Black Panther wasn't stopped. Black Panther was on steroids. Black Panther in week three led the domestic box office again with $65 million. And tonight, which is the fourth week of its release, it's in a battle with A Wrinkle in Time. And some estimates predict the Black Panther to earn between $35 and $40 million tonight, only domestically. Black Panther is the king of the box office, and it's looking to cross $1 billion, and it just may do that tonight. And if it doesn't tonight, it'll definitely do it by the weekend, which will be Sunday. Black Panther is currently sitting in accordance to Box Office Mojo. The Black Panther is currently sitting at $240 million, and again, as I just said, it's projected to make $35 to $40 million tonight. It's competing, as I said earlier, with A Wrinkle in Time, and this is the big one. It was released in China on March the 9th. Today was released in China, and it's projected to make in China between $60 and $70 million. It is currently tracking in China ahead of Spider-Man Homecoming, also Thor Ragnarok. And Spider-Man Homecoming, as far as its total run in China, made $120 million. And Thor Ragnarok, in its entire run in China, made $112 million. And again, Black Panther is currently tracking ahead of Spider-Man Homecoming and Thor Ragnarok. And it's sitting at $140 million tonight, before those box offices are even included. So look for Black Panther to go over the $1 billion mark, most likely probably tonight, if not tonight, tomorrow. But what an accomplishment. What an accomplishment to be making this type of money for a relatively unknown type of character. So begs the question, how much will Black Panther make? Will it beat the Avengers, which made an overall gross of $1.5 billion? Will it beat Age of Ultron, who made $1.4 billion? Will it beat Iron Man 3, who made $1.2 billion? And will it beat Civil War, which made $1.1 billion? I believe it's an honor. It's saying a lot for Marvel Studios that you can take these type of characters, again, a relatively unknown character, an obscure one, put him at the forefront and look what he can do. And he only had a little appearance in Captain America Civil War, and look what he's done with his individual standalone movie. So, wow. And this movie is, like I said, basically an origin story. So, all hail the king of the box office, T'Challa, the king of Wakanda. So, great news for Black Panther. Again, my hat is off to Marvel. The job they have done, the job and the vision that Kevin Feige has instilled in this group, and it's just a wonderful thing that they have done. When Black Panther goes over $1 billion, it will be the fifth entry in the Marvel franchise to make that much. The Avengers made over $1 billion. Age of Ultron, The Avengers 2, Age of Ultron made over $1 billion. Iron Man 3 made over $1 billion. Captain America Civil War made over $1 billion. And now the Black Panther will be joining the billion-dollar club. So, I mean, what a week. I mean, what a week for Marvel. And also, some additional news for Marvel. Marvel is really feeling the oats right now, really on steroids. So they had a photo shoot with Entertainment Weekly magazine, and they had basically a cover up where multiple characters appeared on different covers of the Entertainment Weekly magazine, and it looked great. It was showing some new technology in some of their appearances. Thor had a different look. Iron Man was showing the bleeding edge armor. Spider-Man was showing the Iron Spider suit. And it was just really, really interesting. So everything now, as far as the Marvel Cinematic Universe, is shifting to the Infinity Wars. And Black Panther fans should be happy too, because Black Panther has been such a boon for Marvel. The way it's going to parlay over into the Infinity Wars is going to be absolutely incredible. So now with the focus shifting on the Infinity War, a lot of Black Panther fans are going to be very excited as well, because a couple of the Wakandans, in addition to just finishing Black Panther, they're going to also appear in the Infinity War. That'll be Shuri, the tech whiz of Wakanda, and also T'Challa, the Black Panther's sister, and it'll also be Okoye, his general of the Dora Milaje. She will also have, and from what I hear with Kevin Feige, they're going to have pretty substantial roles in Infinity War. I mean, good luck, Russo brothers. I mean, how are you guys going to put all of that with everything that you have already in that movie? But I tell you what, I have confidence in Marvel, their layout and their plan and what they're trying to do. They have never been a disappointment. Their movies have always been of quality. So although I see it as, can perceive it as possibly something difficult to do, again, I have confidence in the MCU, and I believe they're going to be able to pull it off. Along with the spread they had for Entertainment Weekly, it also gave some information, disclosed some information. So now we know of some battle locations were clarified thanks to the Entertainment Weekly review. So we know that there are going to be certain theaters of battle. We know that New York is going to be a battle scene, because we saw that portal, that circular portal coming out of the sky in New York. We also know that Wakanda is going to be one of the theaters of battle, because we all saw them all lined up in that run-to scene where both armies were about to clash. That, of course, was in Wakanda. And everyone has been saying, me personally, I said in a previous video, that planet that looks destroyed, that looks desolated and has objects floating all around, I thought it was Xandar. Because once I saw that Thanos had the Power Stone, I figured he had went to Xandar, took the Power Stone, and maybe just leveled the whole planet. But from what I hear, Kevin Feige says that's actually a picture. That battle is going to take place on Thanos' homeworld, Titan. So Titan is destroyed. So we'll see how that goes. So Kevin Feige confirmed that site is actually Titan. So now we know the theaters of battle. So the theaters of battle in Black Panther is going to be Earth. They're going to have the space battle, which will be on Titan. And of course, the third act, the big one, the creme de la creme, that big fight is going to be staged in Wakanda. And the way Kevin Feige has explained it, the heroes are going to be separated. It's going to be teams of heroes. I think the trailers have showed everyone that much, where you see Thor with the Guardians of the Galaxy, and you see Doctor Strange with Iron Man and Spider-Man, and you see Captain America with the Black Panther, and they seem to be in Wakanda. So you can get the gist that the teams look like they're all spread out. But from what I hear, everybody is going to come and converge on Wakanda when that third act and that big battle takes place. And the way that Entertainment Weekly laid out the magazine, they had it 22 heroes, 6 Infinity Stones, 1 Mad Titan. So it is going to be an epic battle. It is going to be something that probably has never been seen before. And with Black Panther making all of this money, a $1 billion movie, what a feather to stick in the cap for Marvel, because they're going to have two films back to back that are going to gross $1 billion plus. I mean, because if anyone thinks Infinity War won't do $1 billion, I tell you what, if Black Panther had made $700 or $800 million, that would have been a huge success. If Infinity War don't make $1 billion, at least, that's going to be a huge disappointment. So I'm looking at it, the former, that two movies from Marvel back-to-back, Black Panther, Infinity War, both are going to be in competition with each other as far as the box office. And I do believe that ultimately that Infinity War will be the highest grossing Marvel movie of all time. I look for Infinity War to make more money than the original Avengers that made $1.5 billion. So Kevin Feige, in addition to the interview, also said that things are about to be reset in the MCU. He said that he's heard the complaints and people talking about nobody really dies, there's no real stakes, and some people that have allegedly died always seems to come back in return. Well, Kevin Feige touched base on that, and what he said is not going to make Marvel fans happy. He says that there will be stakes in Infinity War, and that people will die. And when they will die and be dead forever. And I'm not too sure how I feel about that. Because it's going to be a lot of emotion going into Infinity War. And it's going to be emotion because these are characters that we have invested in for 10 years. And I don't care who your characters are that you like. If you are a fan of Hawkeye, if he dies, I will feel bad for him. If the Scarlet Witch dies, I would feel bad for her. If Hulk dies, let's go with some of the not some of the minor figures. If Hawkeye died, I would feel absolutely terrible. If War Machine died in Infinity War, I would feel terrible. If Falcon died in Infinity War, I would feel terrible. If Black Widow died, I would feel terrible. So these are characters that people have invested 10 years in, seeing them fleshed out, seeing them develop, seeing their trials and their tribulations over a 10-year period. And now Feige is talking shit like some of them may be gone, wiped out. So I look for Infinity War to be a very emotional movie. That's probably going to be very heartfelt, very emotional. And it shows some of the photos that it's showing, that photo that they released in D23 and Comic-Con where Thanos grabs a planet and hurls a planet at the Avengers. Now we know that site is actually, it's a place they're going to be fighting on Titan, and planets and Thanos can throw planets at people. I hope they release that in the next trailer that's due to come out. I'm looking for that trailer to come out anytime now, because everyone knows they've moved Avengers Infinity War up a week to April the 27th as opposed to May the 4th. So they're doing a lot of promotion with it now, a lot of stories, a lot of things are leaking. All news all day is now going to be leaks of Infinity War and what's going on to that, because Marvel has an excellent stewardship as far as being able to flip the switch from one to the other. And now Black Panther did its run and has made so much money. Now the emphasis, while Black Panther is still making money, now the emphasis, all the publications, all of the promotion is all being leveled now for Infinity Wars. So, I mean, it's going to be something epic. I'm looking forward to it. I'm going to take a box of Kleenex in there when I go, because it's going to be, I know I'm going to leave out of there crying. So I don't know. What do you think? I'm going to leave some contact information in the comments section. So if you want to get in touch with me, give me some ideas, let me know what you think, you'll be able to do so. Thanks for looking, and this was The Expanse.